वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट मैटर लेसन 4 केमिस्ट्री। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ मैटर, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैटर इनटू सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैस ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर प्रॉपर्टीज, अरेंजमेंट ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स इन सॉलिड्स, लिक्विड्स एंड गैसेस, इंट्रामोलिकुलर स्पेस, कोहेसिव फोर्स एंड ब्राउनियन मूवमेंट, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर इन डिफरेंट स्टेट्स, इफेक्ट ऑफ हीट ऑन मैटर। So this chapter you have already studied before. So again we will study. Let's see. If you look around, you will find a large number of things. They all look different and have properties different from one another. However, all these things are made up of matter. For example, horse, mango tree, dog, animals, plants are living, while stone, pen, glass, water, book, table, air are all non-living. So you will find both living and non-living matter. So what is the definition of matter? Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. Okay, so and mass is always same at all places. For example, the food you eat, the water you drink, and the air you breathe are all made up of matter. Now, is there anything that is not matter? Heat, light, electricity, sound, vacuum, and shadow, they are not matter because they neither have mass nor do they have space. Okay, for example, given see feelings of love, affection, sadness, etc., these are also not categorized under matter because they don't have any space and have mass. So now we will study about characteristics of matter. As in the definition it has said about space and mass, so these are the two characteristics of matter. So first one is matter occupies space. All things occupy space. For example, if you put a stone into a glass filled completely with water and some water will overflow. This is because the stone replaces the water to occupy its space in the glass. So it contains space. Okay, the stone uses this space in the glass, so the water overflows. Things such as air, which we cannot see, also occupy space. The amount of space occupied by matter is called its volume. Next is matter has mass. The amount of matter contained in an object is known as its mass. More the amount of matter in an object, greater is the mass. For example, the body of an elephant has a greater amount of matter than that of monkey because elephant is bigger than the monkey. So elephant has more mass than a monkey. And you should know that matter is of two types, okay? Living and non-living matter. So what is living matter? Living matter contains all kinds of plants and animals, whereas non-living matter, you will find everything in the universe because it does not grow, move or reproduce on its own. And it can be of two types, that is natural and man-made matter. Okay, so now classification of matter. So matter has classified into three groups, that is solid, liquid or gas. Next here one activity is given. Classify the following into solid, liquid and gas. Here see wood, solid, eraser, solid, oxygen, gas, petrol, liquid, common salt, solid, then water, liquid, hydrogen, gas, milk, liquid, water vapor, gas, pencil, solid, air, gas. Now a question arises, what is the difference between these three groups of things? So the answer is the difference lies in their shape and volume. So let us study about them in detail. Okay. So a substance, depending on its temperature, can exist in three forms, that is solid, liquid or gas. Solid, liquid and gas are called three states of matter. A substance can exist in different states because the difference in the arrangement of molecules. And The smallest particle of which matter is made up of is the atom. The smallest unit of matter is its molecule. So it is all about the arrangement of molecules. The molecules of a substance are held together by a force of attraction between them. Okay, this is known as intermolecular force of attraction. Like see here a diagram is given. Okay, solid, liquid, this is gas. So these round you can see these are considered as molecules. So you can see the arrangement of molecules in case of solid. See the molecules are closely packed. Then here in liquid little apart. Then in case of gas more firm. Okay, so intermolecular force of attraction is more in case of solid, little less in case of liquid, and more less in case of gas. Okay. Now, depending upon the strength of intermolecular force, the space between the molecules vary for different states of matter. This space is known as intermolecular space. So, here in diagram, you can see between the solids, no space is there. So, less intermolecular space. It's almost negligible. In case of liquid, you can see, find the space between the two molecules. Okay, in case of gas, more space between the two molecules. Okay, so the intermolecular force of attraction and intermolecular force, intermolecular space is both are inversely proportional to each other. So more is the space, less is the force of attraction. So today we will study this much. Next class we will study about arrangement of molecules in the three states of matter. Okay, so go through the chapter and read thoroughly. Thank you.